So my question today is, are you getting enough sulfur in your diet? And what is sulfur and what is it good for? And how would this apply to your health? Well, sulfur is really, really important in several aspects. Number one, it's needed to make two very important amino acids. Okay, one's called methionine and the other one is called cysteine. Now, methionine is an essential amino acid, which means you must get it from your diet. Your body cannot make it. Yet cysteine can be made from your body, but you need sulfur to make both of these amino acids. And sulfur is also very important in making the antioxidant glutathione, which has a very important function in detoxification, especially in your liver, for many different things. In fact, if you're deficient in glutathione, you're going to build up too much hydrogen peroxide, and that can actually lead to a whole bunch of things. One being your hair becomes prematurely gray, and you're just going to have a hard time clearing toxins from the body. Sulfur is very necessary in making keratin, which is essential for your hair, nails, and skin. It gives the structure of your skin. So if you're not getting enough keratin because you don't have enough sulfur, your skin's going to become loose. Sulfur is necessary in making insulin. And if you've been watching any of my videos, you know how important that is. Number three, it's involved in collagen synthesis. So without sulfur, you can't make collagen, which makes up your joints. And if you're deficient in that, you're going to have all sorts of problems with joints falling apart. And this is why a lot of the supplements for joints involve sulfur. Also, methionine has been known to decrease kidney stones in dogs. So if your dog has kidney stones, start giving it methionine. Methionine is important in keeping your histamines low to prevent allergies. So some people take methionine to help with allergies and even asthma. And number seven, it's intimately involved in phase one, phase two detoxification. So if there's a poison that comes in your body, like something that can cause cancer, sulfur-based methionine is needed to help clear out these poisons. And so if you're low on sulfur or methionine, you're going to build up a lot more toxins in your body. And you could even be more susceptible to getting cancer because these chemicals can't be cleared from the body. Sulfur is also needed to make vitamin B1, thiamine, as well as biotin. Rats fed without the amino acid methionine develop fatty livers. And so where do we get sulfur? Well, it's in fish, it's in seafood, it's in beef, it's in eggs, it's in cheese, it's in garlic, onions, Brussels sprouts, in cabbage. But the form of sulfur in plants is different than in animal products. It's in an inorganic form, which means that most of the sulfur-based compounds in your body are going to come more from the animal-based products versus the inorganic form. So in other words, if you're relying on your sulfur just from plants, you may be deficient. Now, what situations could occur if you might be deficient in sulfur? Number one, if you're taking a lot of acetaminophen, which is going to deplete your sulfur because you need more sulfur to get rid of this chemical. So anything of a toxic nature or anything involving medications or drugs or anything, you're going to need more sulfur to get rid of it. Also, you're going to need more sulfur if you have an infection, if you're exposed to toxins, and if you're consuming proteins with either no or low methionine, like in fruit, most vegetables, excluding garlic, onions, Brussels sprouts, and cabbage, and legumes. And so if your diet is primarily fruits, vegetables, and legumes, you're going to have an incomplete protein. You're going to have to substitute your diet with more methionine. Also, if you're estrogen dominant or you have a lot of estrogen through your body, let's say you're taking birth control pills or hormone replacement therapy, you're going to need more sulfur to detoxify estrogen as well. So in summary, make sure you're consuming enough fish, seafood, beef, eggs, cheese, and definitely garlic, onions, Brussels sprouts, and cabbage. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.